The black outlined animated logo for accessible lines features a short pencil lying on its side, the sharp point to the right. There is a smiley face where the rubber should be, and this spins round clockwise. Inside the pencil, a line fluctuates like a sound wave, rippling and changing from red to blue. Accessible lines is written under the pencil.
Accessible lines.
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 Scrap Me Baby One More Time. Digital Illustration 2023. Created and described by Gizem Güvendağ. My childhood memories of public Turkish baths called hamam inspired this illustration. In this illustration, five female figures are bathing in a hamam. The figures have warmer color tones, contrasting the background of the hamam, which has cold blue-purple tones. The illustration style is mostly flat painted without gradients. The outlines of the figures are red, and there are some small spray-like shadows or blushes on these characters. Their bodies are large, but their heads are proportionally smaller. The central figure in the front and the middle, dominating the image and appearing right in front of us, is a bit fleshy compared to the others and has red-orange hair and flecks. She is sitting on a marble structure typical of Turkish hammams. She is rubbing her right breast with a coarse butt glove. Her right breast is enormous, and since she is washing herself underneath, this breast is pointing upwards and seems unfeasibly large, more prominent than her head, with a big orange nipple. This is a typical scene from my childhood hammam memories. Her left breast is not there. Instead, there is a surgical scar. She has a green towel over her thighs with just a few flecks of red pubic hair showing. On the left side of the illustration, but on the right side of the main character, in the middle, is a woman combing her curly brown hair. Her facial expression shows that she is having difficulty getting the comb through her curls. Her upper part is also naked. She has full breasts, and a red and white checked towel is tied around her waist. She rests her right elbow on the edge of a water basin. On the right side of the image, to the left of the central figure, is an older woman with white hair standing up while pouring water from her head with a bowl. She has sagging older breasts. A light green towel is tied around her waist. On her left, to our right, two more figures smiling and chatting. One blonde woman with a green and red checked towel around her is massaging with a foam the one sitting in front of her. The one sitting on a marble has broader shoulders and a masculine body. The dominant emotions in these visuals are mirth and joy. The environment is steamy, wet, and hot. There are some yellow jugs and bowls to use to pour water. Decoration in the hammam is typical for Turkish hammams, including some basic ornaments. We can imagine laughter and light-hearted conversations echoing through the marble decoration of the hammam and the sound of the running water from the fountains.
The Market Square, Pyrography and Embroidery on Calico, 2021, an illustration from the graphic novel called The Dancing Plague, created and described by Gareth Brookes. The scene takes place in a medieval street. A crowd of people stand around talking in the centre, dressed in medieval clothes. Most appear from their clothing to be peasants or townsfolk, and they're drawn in a burnt brown. The crowd and the wooden buildings behind them have been drawn in fine ink-like lines using a burning tool on cloth. You can almost smell the singed textile fibres. There are 10 figures visible in the crowd, and a few more are partially visible at the back of the gathering. A woman stands on the far left, her back to us, carrying a wicker basket. She is talking to a bald, bearded man who is facing us. In the centre of the crowd, a falconer holds a bird on his outstretched hand towards a woman in a brown dress. On the far right, a one-legged beggar leans on a crutch. Surrounding the crowd are medieval buildings reinforced with wooden beams. Towards the back of the crowd, a woman raises her arms. The lower half of her body is partially obscured by the figures at the front. She seems to be being lifted up. Holding her arms on one leg and floating above the crowd are four huge, brightly coloured demons pulling the woman upwards. They're depicted using embroidered running stitch in four different colours. The red demon to the left is yanking the woman's leg upwards. It has wings, a claw-like foot like a chicken, a plumed tail, and a bird-like crest on its head, which is thrown backwards as if it is exerting a great effort in tugging the woman's leg. Behind it is a blue demon, the largest of the four, with its gigantic wings spread across the entire image. The demon looks like a dragon, but it has a beak, horns, and floppy ears like a dog. There is a human face on the demon's torso, and its snake-like body is coiled around the other demons. Behind and to the right of this demon is a third demon, embroidered in aqua green stitching. This demon also has wings and is smiling maniacally as it pulls the arms of the woman upwards. Finally, there is a yellow demon with a long sausage-like body coiled behind the green demon. Its dog-like legs and tail are kicking outwards towards the right of the image, just above the one-legged beggar. Its horned head is close to the woman's head, and it is sticking out its pointy tongue as it looks at her. The dull brown colour and lack of movement of the crowd is in stark contrast to the colourful action and movement of the demons that dominate the image above them. The crowd standing around on the cobbled street seem unaware of the huge demons above them and are talking amongst themselves casually. The woman at the centre of the image, who is being grabbed and pulled upwards by the demons, is wide-eyed and open-mouthed. She looks terrified.
A Seat at the Table, Digital Illustration, 2018. Created and described by Hatiye Garip. The illustration is drawn without outlines, in vivid colors and simple shapes, in a cheerful and childlike style. The background of the illustration is a bright, dark orange. Yellow, pink, green, blue and purple stand out throughout the illustration. A group of six adults with various disabilities are sitting around a large yellow rectangular table. They seem to be having a meeting or discussing something. By the expressions on their faces, it doesn't look like one of those boring meetings. On the short left side of the table, a chubby woman with long white hair and albinism is sitting. She smiles as if she is happy to have the best seat. She is wearing a salmon-colored blouse, a bright turquoise skirt above her knees, and dark brown boots. On the far, long side of the table, two people sit with mugs and books in front of them. The one on the left is a medium light-skinned, blind woman with a braille book. She is wearing blue and cool glasses. Her long black hair and an earring in one ear attract attention. Next to her is an imposing, medium dark-skinned man with a pink shirt and headphones. His facial expression is calmer than the others. On the short right side of the table sits a light-skinned man with a purple goatee, mustache, and hair in a bun. His feet do not touch the floor because he is a little person. He is wearing a blue jumper, black skinny jeans, and purple shoes. On the near long side of the table are two people with their backs turned. The one on the left is a petite, light-skinned woman. She has short ginger hair styled in a bob. She is wearing a maroon blouse and is using a wheelchair. Her cheek and the wheels of her chair are the same shade of pink. She looks to the right and listens to the person next to her with a smile. A black man with curly hair is sitting next to her. He is wearing a white top and dark green trousers. There is a black crutch behind his chair. All the figures are together and in the center of the illustration, as if they are saying, "There is no need for the details about the place. Our table is enough."
Our eyes meet. Digital in Illustration 2021. Created and described by Sahali. Against a white background, there are three separate pencil drawings, each contained by hand-drawn rectangular boxes in landscape format, resembling a comic book narrative style. The drawings are displayed in parallel on top of each other. The drawings are monochrome in style, using a simple palette of black and royal blue pencil. The space around the subjects of the drawings is filled using black and royal blue watercolor textures. The first drawing on top is the largest, depicting the head of a jaguar looking to the left, focusing on something beyond the hand-drawn frame. The jaguar's head is drawn in detail, with its individual pattern markings, textured hairs on its ears, and outline of its nose with subtle yet soft pencil drawings. A third of the space is taken up with royal blue watercolor paint behind its head, and its body filled in black contrasts sharply with the background. Below this, a second drawing illustrates a pair of jaguar eyes, which are looking straight ahead directly at the viewer. The eyes are stark and focused. The expression is trusting yet inquisitive, giving a sense of uncertainty. Below this, the final drawing depicts the artist's eyes staring ahead, aligning with the jaguar's eyes to show a parallel connection with each other. The jaguar's eyes are in blue, striking a contrast against black eyes of the artist. Both pairs of eyes are fixed straight ahead, their gaze contemplative and thoughtful.
Pride. Digital Illustration 2022. Created and described by Beyza, Durmuş. This is a colorful and vibrant illustration of a person dancing on top of a rainbow. Created as a tribute to Pride Month and queer joy, it's about how being true to yourself can feel chaotic and overwhelming, but also very bright and cheerful at the same time. The background is warm, seashell-toned white, with the foreground dominated by multicolored lines and shapes that create an abstract texture. Even though this is a digital illustration, it makes use of grainy textures throughout so that it resembles something made with crayons. In the middle of the illustration, there is a standing figure colored in all black, captured mid-pose as they balance on one leg by reaching above as if they are dancing. Behind that person is a big dynamic ribbon of a rainbow, starting at the upper left of the illustration, curving to the right and left throughout the work, and ending on the bottom right of the image. Surrounding the central figure and rainbow, there are various objects and symbols that add depth to the composition. There are pink and red flowers next to the figure's left arm and right leg. There are small dots, lines, and scratches scattered throughout the background. A blue star with a red dot sits on the left side of the rainbow, while on the right side, there's a pair of big eyes with hearts inside of them. There are also drawings of stars, a red sun, fat squiggly lines, a blue butterfly, and a red smiley face. Using so many elements and so many colors, the aim is to capture the essence of pride, celebrating the vibrant spectrum of individuality and the joy of embracing one's true colors.
Kriwi, Illuminating the World, Digital Painting, 2023, created and described by Lynne Hood. The artwork is painted using digital brushes with the colours layered on top of each other to give some texture, so it is not completely flat. The art style is influenced by late Victorian illustrations, realistically rendered with richly coloured hues, such as you would find in a fairy story or mythology book of the era. In the illustration, the Welsh goddess Kriwi, depicted as a young, blind Caucasian woman of slender build, walks barefoot confidently through a moonlight winter forest. Her figure is central to the illustration, almost as high as the canvas, and surrounded by trees and foliage which take up the rest of the space. The forest is dark, but around Kriwi is a circle of light. Her eyes are white, depicting that she is blind, and she has a determined expression. She wears a dark red dress which falls below her knees, and her light blonde hair falls freely to her waist. Under her left arm, to the viewer's right, she carries a white swan, symbolizing rebirth. In her right hand, to the viewer's left, she holds a fiery wooden stave before her. Small flames lick upwards in orange and yellow hues, emanating from the stave. Kriwi is in no danger of burning herself. The stave is not to illuminate her path, but to light the way for others metaphorically, as she is alone. Kriwi is surrounded by tall brown-hued tree trunks, leaning at slight angles. A few small leaves of light brown and orange cling to the spindly branches. A trail of long evergreen leaves hang above her head towards the left of the illustration. She walks upon a forest floor of deep green moss. Brighter green leaves with small dots and ferns grow beneath the trees, and scattered around are small white puffball mushrooms and skeletons of delicate dried out flowers. Around the edges of the illustration are silhouettes of trees and leaves, giving us the impression we are looking at Kriwi through a clearing in the woods. High in the sky, against a deep blue night sky, a full white moon glimmers through tree branches. The atmosphere of the illustration is one of boldness. Kriwi is blind and visionary. She blazes her path through the darkness, and her blindness will not stop her achieving her ambitions.
A Dream Scene in Mudanya. Pencil Drawing, 2019. A scene from an animated short, a work in progress. Created and described by Akile, Nazlı, Kaya. A black and white pencil drawing of a young girl looking out to sea at night, where she is surrounded by multiple moons that shine bright in various different sizes. She is located on the lower left side of the drawing. She is drawn from the back, standing and gazing out with a relaxed posture so that we can feel a peaceful atmosphere surrounding the whole scene. She has big curly hair and wears a simple dress, leggings, and boots. On the right lower side of the drawing, there is the biggest moon, which dominates the whole scene, and it is twice as big as the girl. The girl takes up about a third of the height of the drawing, but she seems quite tiny by the moons. The moons are floating close to her.
as if she could touch them with her hand, which makes the scene dreamy and surreal. The girl's hair is in big curls, almost circular. They have a similar shape to the moon's. The moons are drawn in a two-dimensional form, as if they are made from paper. The horizon is placed very low, making the picture even more two-dimensional without much depth. It's an orderly yet busy image that makes the viewer feel hypnotized, but at the same time feels calm and rested. Each moon has a bright paper white color with a soft grainy texture on the surface, filled with a few lines and dots. There is a white halo that surrounds them and gradually shades into the sky, which is completely black and is drawn with scratchy pencil lines. The sea, which is down below the moons and the girl, is quite dark and has few waves. The areas where the moons are close to the sea are in lighter shades. The whole drawing has sharp edges with rounded corners, as if in old photographs, and some of the moons are spilling out of the edges of the frame. A tiny metaphor is hidden in this picture. It was actually a dream that I had more than 10 years ago. In the dream, I was in Mudanya, a summer village in Bursa, standing by the Sea of Marmara at night, looking at the many, many moons around me. So that young girl is me. I started to draw the picture a few years ago, in 2019, and by that time, I was in the process of having in vitro fertilization. As I completed the picture, I suddenly realized the fact that the moons actually look like the eggs collected from ovaries, magnified under a microscope. So for me, this drawing is about amazement and, at the same time, hope.
You can speak to him too. Digital Illustration 2023. Created and described by Ben O'Brien. The illustration depicts a simple scenario with three men. It is a flat graphic illustration with minimal details and textures. One man is standing alone on the left of the illustration. He has brown hair and is wearing a casual blue sweater and black trousers. He has smart white shoes and he is facing the other two men. The two men are on the right-hand side of the illustration, making their way towards the man on the left. One of the two men together is a wheelchair user, an older man with grey hair, and the other is a younger man with ginger hair, a beard and glasses. The younger man is pushing the wheelchair. The older man using the wheelchair is wearing a black sweater, blue trousers and brown shoes. The younger man is wearing a black hooded sweater, dark green trousers and white sneakers. The man on the left is speaking, which is indicated by a speech bubble. The speech bubble only contains three dots to represent speech. There are no actual words. He is speaking directly to the young man pushing the wheelchair, as their heads are at the same height. He is not bending or looking downwards to speak to the wheelchair user. The background is a flat pink, split into two lighter and darker tones. It is split horizontally just below the heads of the two men who are conversing, the man on the left and the younger man on the right. The split in the background helps to show that the man on the left is speaking directly to the younger man walking, and not the wheelchair user. Along the bottom of the illustration is a light brown strip, which depicts the street level that the three men are on. The illustration is telling the story of the artist's own experiences with his disabled father. Frequently in public, people would ignore the father or not communicate with him directly, and only communicate with the father's family members.
The logo for Accessible Lines appears again. The text then changes to Coming Soon and finally to AccessibleLines.com. The project is led by Hatiye Garip and funded by the British Council.
Audio description training delivered by Anne Hornsby from Mind's Eye.
Proofreading by Zeynep, Şölen, Yıldız.
Proofreading, sound design, arrangements and audio production by Paddy Johnston.
Advice on sound design is provided by Peter Bosher.
Animations and videos created by Tolga Sertkaya.